Alistair, really good to meet you, and thanks for coming in for your health screen. I'm going to just run through a few basic questions about your various systems, your heart, your lungs, your eyes, your energy, etc. And how do you feel at the moment? Do you feel fine, lots of energy?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Good.
Let's start from the top and work down. In terms of your eyesight, how is your eyesight?
I wear reading glasses,
yeah.
But I also have a lazy eye. So my left eye is basically minimal function.
And any problems with your hearing?
No.
No. Have you had any issues with nasal congestion, throat problems, anything like that? No?
No. Right.
Any difficulty swallowing?
No.
Any problems with indigestion, acid reflux?
Very, very rarely. I mean, to the minimal point where it's obviously something I've just eaten that moment rather than on a regular basis.
And you haven't passed any blood or slime or mucus with the bowel motions?
Not at all, no.
How has your weight been over the last 12 months?
Fairly consistent. I know that I'm a few pounds overweight. I currently weigh about 82, 83 kilos, something like that.
Do you smoke?
No.
Were you ever a smoker?
No smoking at all.
Do you drink alcohol?
Yes.
And how much alcohol do you drink?
About 26 units a week.
Okay. Right.
Which is a little on the higher side. Yeah.
Do you have, is that spread out over 7 days or is it, do you have alcohol-free days?
Normally I'll have two or three alcohol-free days a week.
But you have days off, which is very, very important to give your liver a little bit of a break. But tell me about your cholesterol. You said in the past it's been slightly high?
I had a test about 7 years ago, and at that point it was definitely about 7 point something. I can't remember exactly what it was, but it was definitely heightened, and I was quite surprised because I thought, I'm not that overweight, my diet isn't that bad, you know, so that was a bit of a shock, but it was good to find out, so at least I knew that I could do something about it.
I mean, cholesterol is one of the things that we will look at today, so, you know, when you're doing a health screen, I suppose we're looking for common things and the common causes of you know, morbidity and mortality in our general patients. So, cardiovascular disease, so heart disease, strokes. So we're looking at parameters like cholesterol, blood pressure, that type of thing. Okay, diabetes is a very big problem for the UK at the moment. Very much so directly related to the fact that our population is getting larger. We will also look at your basic parameters of liver function, kidney function. And then in terms of cancers, which of course is something that we're seeing more and more of, lifetime risk currently of cancer is now 1 in 3 from the day you're born till the day you die. So it's very, very important to know what the important major cancers. So in someone of your age, you'd be looking at skin cancer, bowel cancer, and prostate cancer, and checking various markers. So to assess those, we'll have a look at your skin. We'll do a blood test for prostate. We've obviously got a handle on your symptoms. We'll check your urine, and we can also check your prostate gland. In terms of skin cancer, we'll have a look at all your moles. And then in terms of bowel screening, and this is the test that most patients don't like doing, we'll give you a little specimen pot so that you can give us a sample of your bowel motions, and then that will be analyzed looking for hidden blood. Okay?
Okay.
So through the blood work, we will pick up a lot. It tells us a lot based on your examination, your history, and your blood. It sort of pieces all the jigsaw together. We join the dots. And the key thing is really what we want to do is we want to do age-appropriate screening. Common things are common at particular decades in your life. So, you know, we need to focus on what's important. Yes, of course, you could check for every single thing under the sun and you could scan head to toe and do a million blood tests. But the key thing is focusing on the important things and the things that are likely in someone of your age. Medicine is very, very prejudiced once you go over the age of 50, and therefore we're a lot stricter about things like blood pressure and weight and things that we analyse, and we look at things and symptoms much more closely and have a higher incidence, I guess, of referring people for further tests based on what we find. So you can get away with a lot when you're younger, so unfortunately, we might be a little bit stricter on you.